Boards and executive teams of acquiring banks need to know that the need for stable, low-cost deposits has made smaller, more rural banks more attractive. Acquiring banks need to look at the selling bank's deposit mix and their deposit runoff. If the selling bank's already incurring deposit runoff prior to the acquisition, it will certainly worsen during and after the acquisition. So acquiring banks need to look at that deposit mix and need to look at the systems and initiatives that the selling bank put in place in order to grow and support those deposit accounts. Will the acquiring bank continue to support those mechanisms, or will they strip those away as part of their cost-save initiatives? Finally, acquiring banks need to realize that what they've done in the past in terms of acquisition due diligence may not be 100% relevant going forward. We commonly see acquiring banks focus solely on the systems side of the integration and not enough on the cultural people side of the integration. And the people side is more than just who do we keep and who don't we keep. We see acquiring banks really underemphasize the potential cultural differences between themselves and the seller. And we see acquiring banks often underestimate the cost saves that can be part of the transaction, and then they underperform to the pretty mediocre benchmarks that they set for themselves. We see acquiring banks disregard best practices that the seller may have in place in terms of the seller's products and services because the acquiring bank thinks that they're already doing everything as good as they possibly can. And finally, we see an over-reliance on technology vendors to manage the integration project. Technology vendors don't have the same objectives as the bank. Banks can overcome these errors by developing an integration playbook with metrics based on their own acquisition strategy. Acquiring banks should develop a steering committee that consists of subject matter experts from both the acquiring bank and the selling bank. They should not outsource the project lead to their technology vendor, because technology vendors don't have the same objectives as either the acquiring or the selling bank. And they should consider getting outside help from an experienced team who can focus solely on the integration. Finally, they should designate company culture coaches to assist with the people side of the integration. Additional advice for bank leaders who want to maximize the success of their acquisition would be to remember that conversion weekend is not the end of the project. It's not the end, it's the beginning of the end. The project team leader and the key subject matter experts should remain fully committed to the project for 30 days post-conversion, and culture-related activities should remain in place for 6 months post-conversion. Selling banks need to know that today's M&A environment is highly competitive. We expect that M&A activity in 2019 may increase due to continued strong earnings by acquiring banks and relatively good stock prices. Importantly, selling banks need to know that their vendor contracts, and specifically the buyout clauses in those contracts, can significantly impact deal price. Tips for potential sellers who wish to get the best price for the bank would be to resolve any compliance issues and be very transparent about potential compliance deficiencies. Banks need to remember that if they're not a buyer, they're a potential seller. So clean up your vendor contracts and resolve any compliance issues. Finally, acquiring and selling banks need to strengthen their bottom line by effectively managing non-interest expense and increasing non-interest income.